Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We can see this thing, because we're wearing the spectacles of spectacle. It's, Al-Alai. I don't know if we dare talk to this thing. Because we're wearing it, got it for some gnarly elf dude behind us. Well, it says we can detect illusion plus 25%, save versus spells. We can pull an extra planar creature into the prime, but I think by talking to it, that's not what we're doing, because that's a charged effect. Just curious. Yeah, it shows up here.
A simple matter.
If we dare talk, we got it from Xaviak here. Lady Alith Elendara is here, as well as the bartender. Bunch of commoners.
Aye, sword first.
At least stay close. Now, if we take this thing off. Alright. I hate that we. Can't see it anymore. As I suspected, but I wanted to make sure it was true. Hello? Al-Alai? This creature is on another plane of existence and cannot hear you. You must use the spectacles of spectacle to pull it into your world if you wish to speak to it. Huh. So maybe not used in combat? And Garrick, the bard, is here, says, no matter what you do, I will always love you. It matters not what you say, you'll never drive me away. I sing you this song of love. There's no singing here, so why do they let him sing here? I can hear you singing, Garrick. There are some who like my singing, dearest Elith. They can like it somewhere else. Only one singer is allowed here, as you all know. Garrick says, wait, I recognize you, don't I? We have not ventured together. I probably came across him. It's possible. I am Sapphire, hero of Baldur's Gate, but I don't recognize you. We met very briefly, if we did. Well, allow me to change that. I am Garrick, a performer of no little renown, though the house rules regrettingly prevent me from properly exhibiting my talents. Please join me.
Yes, sir.
Tell me your tale. What brings you here? I am looking for a pair of rogues, Safana and Coran. I heard they were here. They're upstairs, I believe. Just follow the shouting, and pray you only interrupt them arguing. Alright, nothing much to say here, because I don't want him joining my party. Let's talk to the bartender. Still need a rest.
You want some whiskey?
Welcome you are, at least till you cannot pay your tab. Beware you well the dark corners of the song. As the guard turn a blind eye to much that happens here. Is there anything I can do for you? Yes. I can't rest. So where's this, Lady Alith? Or Alith?
You are welcome in my sight.
Good morning to you, my lady. I am Lady Alith Elendara, owner of this establishment. How can I be of service to the hero of Baldur's Gate? Well, yes, but she's talking past Minsk and talking to me. You know who I am? There are a few in this city who don't know the Slayer of Saravak. A few more today than yesterday, and a few more than the day before. something wrong there. But your fame grows nearly as fast as the population. These are trying times. How are you holding up with all the refugees coming in? I could use about a dozen more waiting staff and some more people for the kitchen, but overall, I can't complain. There are troublemakers amongst the newcomers, to be sure, but they don't make much trouble here. They're afraid of the ghost? They're afraid of the clientele. Not an unreasonable concern. Some of my patrons have a well-earned reputation for, let's call it, impatience. They like it here and don't respond well to disruptive elements. Have your patrons told you anything of Kalar Argent? The Shining Lady? Those that like her love her, and those that don't loathe her. She's driven the gods know how many from their homes. She's driven the gods know how many from their homes these past months, but of those, many tell of a friend or loved one who fell under her sway, willingly joining her cause even after horrific indignities suffered at her followers' hands. She's a charismatic leader, then. That could cause problems. We needn't worry about Kalar. A pact has been made between the Grand Dukes and the Lords of Waterdeep, and Daggerford's mayor, though I can't imagine that being much help. In any case, Kalar's Sword Coast adventurers will soon be at an end. Hope so. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to fill a few mugs before my customers start complaining. I'm not done talking to you yet.
You are welcome in my sight.
Same thing. Mm. Alright, wait.
You are welcome in my sight.
I was hoping you could help me. Right, right. Garishin, a local homeowner, has opened his house to refugees, but he's in need of provisions to feed those staying under his roof. Hmm. We did just get a few shipment of supplies in. They're in storage upstairs. I could let you have them for 1,000 gold. Oh, we don't have that yet. I hate to ask it, my lady, but is there no way you can see to donate the supplies? These people are in grave need. Well, I suppose I could donate the supplies just this once. Don't let it get around. I've enough people coming to me looking for a handout as it is. The food's in a chest upstairs. Here's the key. Supply chest key. This key opens a chest in the upstairs supply room of the Elfsong Tavern. You can just stick it on this key ring. Garrick says, a gold coin, that's all it takes to hear an epic tale from award-winning balladeer Garrick of the famous Dale Wynn Troubadours. I'm parched. Ally, my darling, fetch me a drink. $23 gold and a potion of healing. Fetch it yourself, you useless caterwauler. Bread, fruit, and other staples of the kitchen are piled on this table. Without ruby wine, no one will stay here. No one. Arena? Talk to Arena.
Oh, it's a fine day for meeting new friends.
We'll be ruined. Ruined. This is the worst red-blooding day of my life. Your pardon, my lady. Is there some way I can be of assistance? I almost can't bear to say it out loud, but our barrels are empty. We're completely sold out of ruby wine. And you're missing some gold and a healing potion as well. That's all? That's all? That's all? What do you mean that's all? You've no idea how many ships we're going to see in the harbor in the next 10 days. Thirsty sailors will be here demanding ruby wine. We'll have none to give them. Hey, you're the hero of Baldur's Gate, aren't you? Sapphire, I recognize you now. You're friendly with the council. What of it? I happen to know Duke Belt has a personal stash of ruby wine in the Ducal Palace cellar. You think you can get me a barrel? You would have me steal from the Ducal Palace? Borrow, steal. Hells, leave some gold in its place for all I care. I just need that wine. How do I recognize ruby wine? It has a really sharp, spicy smell. Ordinary wine just smells winey. You can't truly believe I'll rob the Ducal Palace for you. Suit yourself. It's your loss. A tavern with ruby wine is like a paladin without an attitude.
May you know the happiness of a warm hearth and home.
That wine is our most popular item. What would you give me to do this? Ooh, I have a great reward in mind. Yep, it's really something. But first, bring me the wine. Give me gold enough to buy a barrel of wine. I'll leave that in place of what I take. Fine, here's a purse with 50 gold pieces in it. Leave it in place of the barrel. I'll bring you some as soon as I can sneak into the palace cellar. Hurry back as soon as you have the wine. I could sneak into the cellar of the Ducal Palace to obtain ruby wine. Arena, a halfling employee in the Elfsong Tavern, wants me to pilfer a barrel of ruby wine from the Ducal Palace's cellar. The wine is known to have a sharp, spicy smell. Okay.
You have an unrefined palate.
Why, thank you. I use shallots instead of onions whenever possible. Who wouldn't, right? Who wouldn't? Who dat? Commoner. Tavern will be ruined. I'll be out of a job. Sit yourself down and I'll tell you a tale. I'd play you a tune, but it's called Elf Song for a reason. I guess we can't get in there. Well, before we start messing around with this ghost, let's go upstairs.
Out! Get out, you vile poxy snake!
Alright, that was Safana. I rue the day I heard your wretched name, you weasel. Coran says I'm a weasel and a snake? That doesn't make sense. Yeah, I recognize him. He's a little crazy looking. I've got a dagger, you know. Do you think I won't use it? Go! Get out of here! Get out of here! Okay.
Sword first!
Coran says, well, hello there. How does this morning find you, fair maiden? Well, we met very briefly. Well enough, but I could be better. What are you doing for the next several weeks? Next several weeks. I prefer not to think much beyond the next few hours. I'm afraid I can't help you, friend. No, don't start. My mind is made up. I'll not be swayed by tears. Hey, it's all right. I'm sure you'll manage to muddle through without me. Somehow. Here, have this gem. I acquired it from a lovely elven girl. Lovely, and so quiet. Safana was furious, of course. I should never have taken the damnable thing. But it would have been impolite to refuse, wouldn't it? All right, take care. Hopefully we'll meet again soon under brighter circumstances. Coran will not join me. Why? I found the elven thief, Coran, engaged in a furious argument on the second floor of the Elfsong Tavern. It was a pleasant enough encounter, but he displayed no interest in journeying to Dragonspear. I must go without him. God damn it, I don't want Safana, though. Oh, there's a thug. Why won't he join us? What did he give me? I think I already had it. Or maybe he gave me a water opal? That's funny. Maybe he wouldn't join me because of Dinah here or Minsk. Oh God, he has to be stuck with Safana.
Keep a good distance now.
I have nothing to say to the likes of you. Damn it. I don't want Safana anymore. Okay, Thug is attacking Thug, taking non-lethal damage. What the hell's going on here?
What can it be now?
Buy me a drink or step away. Serving wench.
'Tis always good to give a little tip.
Sift by another table of refugees. A woman can't make any coin in this accursed city. Household guard.
Declare yourself.
No singing. House rule. What's history of the Dragon Coast? I've read that. She's probably going to see us if we go into that. There's another thug.
Let us speak and be done with this.
Be off. I've got my own burdens. I don't know what these guys are up to.
Keep a good distance now.
I can't believe it. You're really the hero of Baldur's Gate. Yes, and I want to enter your stuff. Commoners, I guess we'll talk to one of them. Yeah, I've read that before. This rack holds wine of every variety and vintage, including a fine bottle of Mesember Blush. These guys are attacking each other. Alright, I was gonna look in here. I was distracted by thugs attacking each other. Empty. Mice scurrying over sacks of flour, oats, and ground meal have yet to thaw or gnaw through the burlap. We could probably get into this. What is that? Supplies. A large sack full of provender. Huh. I should bring the provender to Garrison. Oh, right. We were supposed to take that. I wish we were separated from, like, the Dirk Eltan's illness and all that. I secured provender enough for a week of meals for Garrison. Alright. Yeah.
Damn you to all nine hells, Coran! I swear I'm going to... I'm sorry? Who are you?
You don't remember? You're trying to hurt my feelings? It hasn't been that long.
What brings you here at this ungodly hour?
Earlier this night, assassins penetrated the Ducal Palace and attempted to kill me. They were sent by Kalar.
Who?
Kalar Argent, the Shining Lady, the woman responsible for the rising tide of people flowing into this city. We're going to fight her.
Oh, that's why things have been so damnably crowded lately. Interesting.
Interesting in the worst sense of the word. Kalar has to be stopped.
Good luck with that.
I think Timora tends to smile upon those who travel with you. Would you consider joining me?
You would have me accompany you. I see the benefit for you. For me, not so much. But a break from the city, and a certain inhabitant at least, would be welcome. And most likely rewarding, if not a little perilous. Very well, I'm with you.
It's only because we can't find another rogue thief, whatever. Safana has joined my company and she levels up. I seem to have contacted Safana at an opportune time. After some troubles with Coran, she is anxious to be away from her lover. Oh, they're lovers? And the city, both. She will join me on the journey to Dragonspear. Fortunately, if I dismiss Safana, she will travel with the Flaming Fist to their camp at Coastway Crossing. Alright, let's level her up. Alright, so additional weapon proficiencies is 1. She got short bow. She can't use long bow. She's a thief or a rogue. That's a melee weapon. I mean, I could put in a crossbow, but I really have no plans. Yes, why not dagger? Oh, she's got 75. All right. How many times she leveled up? Probably 3. I think she gets 25 points per level. Okay, so open locks, 80. Find traps, 80. Hide in shadows, 80. Detect illusion. Put 30 and then 45 here, move silently. She's level 10 now, all of a sudden. Wow. They didn't let her level up with us in the Korlash family tomb, but now they do. Alright. You know, I didn't look at her biography. When asked about her past, Safana spins tale upon tale involving fantastic liaisons with pirate captains, nobles, and royalty of all shapes and sizes. Her most recent escapades seemed to be truthful. She took up with an elf named Coran, and while the relationship seemed amusing for a time, she and Coran recently parted ways. She confides to you that Coran was just too much, wouldn't stop hanging off me in the most pathetic way. Always on the lookout for the next exciting adventure. and perhaps needing to leave Baldur's Gate for a reason she hasn't shared, Safana joined the expedition to Dragonspear for as long as it remains amusing. Okay. I wonder if we could talk to any of these people now.
What? Such menial tasks.
Yes.
She's having trouble reaching him, maybe. Who's walking? Who's that? What's the thug again? We don't have an option to talk to any of these people.
Fine.
No, nothing happens. Alright then. I wonder what's up with these thugs who attack themselves, or attack each other. So, you know, in here...
You want me? Yes, dear.
And this is her room, so she takes something out of here. 10 gold. I really didn't want...
Ah, it has been too long since Minsk journeyed with such a fine companion.
I really didn't want her in the party. But Coran wouldn't join us. Damn it. Now she's... Their backs are turned. Should be alright, right? Right? 56 gold? Yeah, we need some gold. We have 1100 now. That. Well, there's people in there too. Alright. Alright, let's go.
You want boo? Let's talk more fight!
No fighting yet. Oh yeah, I'm not gonna talk to this thing.
Sweetheart?
Oh, God. Why? Why do I have to be subjected to this? Alright.
What is it?
I have to summon this thing to talk to it. See what happens. Who dares call upon Al-Alai, first fury of the White Forge? I am Sapphire. I only wish to speak to you. Ignorant fool, you have summoned the first fury of the White Forge. Now you will burn. She looks like Ignis from Planescape Torment. Oh boy.
What?
It will end me!
What?
Swing and a miss!
Let's try to cool this guy down. One of the spells has failed. 34 missile damage from Corwin.
This will not work. I must try a different tech.
Oh!
Whatever you like.
She's using her fists.
No need. Right. Yes, yes, dear. Hey there. Yes, dear.
Keep running.
Want me? Yes, dear.
We almost got it.
Sweet, whatever you like.
Yay! I called forth a fire elemental in the Elfsong Tavern. Al-Alai, first fury of the White Forge, attacked me. I was forced to destroy it. Interesting. Yeah, spell over. I mean, battle over. We don't have any healers yet.
Aye.
That. She's gonna take a few.
Your name? Whatever you like.
Alright, we can't loot the thing. The nobleman says, get out of my way, bum. Get out or be thrown out. Don't make me laugh, peasant. Oh boy. The nobleman took one piercing damage. What the hell's going on over there? Bye, nobleman. So, what happened here? Did we get experience? Huh. It doesn't look like we got experience for that. Alright. We're done in here.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, yes.
You've a fair number of friends, but we should head back to the Ducal Palace. You need to get some rest before we head out in the morning.
Oh, we rest there. Mm-hmm. I'm not done in the city yet. I want to finish up a few things first. As you like it, I'll stick with you until you decide to get back to the palace.
Sword first!
Thank you. So... I'm not going shopping here yet. I want all our party members so we can carry all our things, know what we have, and all that fun stuff. Let's talk to this enforcer, why not?
We're more than mercenaries.
Where did all these people come from? The crusade must be moving faster than we thought. There's anyone else to talk to here? Bodyguard and Senna.
Simply no standards these days.
Greetings, ma'am. Senna, the moneylender at your service. What can I help you with this morning? I have a deposit for you from a merchant named Tira. Oh yes, I know Tira. If you'll just give me the deposit, I'll mark it into her account. Here you are. Thank you. You may tell her I've received the deposit and her account has been updated accordingly. Good day to you. I should tell Tira the good news. I successfully deposited Tira's earnings. I should tell her that the matter is handled. Her stall was outside the Ducal Palace. Indeed it was. How'd it go?
Speak quickly, citizen. I have little time for this.
Conduct your business or move along.
The Grand Dukes must do something about this.
A bottle of wine. This wine was obtained after placing the eerily glowing grapes in the wine press and starting the engine. When you breathe deeply, memories of lost loves come rushing back, and you find your eyes filling with tears. Yeah, I remember that. How did it... How did it get from Durlak's tower to here? Really confusing. Let's see if there's anyone up here. No. See this girl has to say.
I want my mommy.
I wish we go back to our old house. My stuffed Tarask is there. She has a stuffed Tarask.
Please, help us.
I've got nothing and no one cares. Not even a stuffed Tarask.
I'm hungry.
That's gonna be our new home. I want my old home back. Out of the way. Out of the way, damn it. That was Corwin saying that. Alright, we're done here. We're gonna move on to the next section. Next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.